Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be talking about a very interesting condition called a pteridium. The spelling of this condition is very interesting, the condition itself is interesting, and hopefully more so you will find the video itself interesting. So please stay tuned to learn more about a pteridium. So the conjunctiva covers the front aspect of your eye, namely the white bit that you see. The white bit that you see is called the sclera, and the conjunctiva is a thin membrane that covers the sclera. A pteridium is basically when you get a fibrovascular growth that can vary in terms of its shape and size, but essentially it starts growing on the conjunctiva. It can either stay localized to the conjunctiva or it can start growing towards the cornea, where if it starts growing on your central visual axis, which is basically when you look at something straight ahead, if it starts encroaching on that central visual axis, it can then start to threaten your vision itself. You may be wondering what causes a pteridium. The answer to this is the risk factors we know of are patients who are exposed to hot, dry environments and environments where there is lots of sunlight and therefore UV exposure. Patients with pteridium may be asymptomatic, i.e. they complain of nothing, or they may have dry, uncomfortable, irritable eyes due to the pteridium. And as I mentioned earlier, if their cornea is also involved, then their vision may be blurry. If the pteridium also develops and starts covering their cornea, it could also change the power of the cornea. So remember, the cornea is a specific shape and therefore it provides the eyeball with a specific power and focus and ability. If the pteridium develops on this cornea, it can affect that power and it can induce something called astigmatism. If you want to learn more about astigmatism, please watch my video, which I have screenshotted above and I will link down below, and you can learn more about what astigmatism is and how it can impact upon one's vision. Depending on how advanced your pteridium is, the management of your pteridium will also vary. For example, if you are asymptomatic, then it may just be observed. If you have mild irritable symptoms, this may be managed with topical lubricants and advice to wear good sunglasses to prevent UV exposure. If, however, it does start to affect your vision, it has started to cause astigmatism and it is growing further and further towards your visual axis and the center of your pupil, then you may be a candidate for surgery. The only way currently to eradicate a pteridium is to perform surgery. Unfortunately, there are no magic drops available that upon installation into the eye will dissolve the pteridium. Patients can become slightly apprehensive about having eye surgery per se. One of the things that patients who are considering pteridium surgery need to be aware of is the fact that in roughly up to 10 out of 100 patients, the pteridium can grow back. So that's something to bear in mind. However, without surgery, if the condition is affecting your vision and it is causing astigmatism, it is only likely to get worse. So that brings me to the end of this short video about pteridium. We have discussed what a pteridium is, we have discussed what the risk factors for this condition are, how it is generally treated, and the impacts that it can have on patients. If you have found this video to be useful, I encourage you to please like, subscribe, and click the bell icon to stay up to date with my latest releases. If you yourself have pteridium, or you had pteridium, or you know somebody that does have pteridium, please do comment below and let me know what your experiences were, how you managed it, and did you have surgery? If you did have surgery, has it come back? I would love to hear your thoughts and views. Thank you so much for watching.